Okay, I'm super excited about this recipe. It's heirloom tomatoes. Tell us a little bit about heirloom tomatoes.
Okay, so if you went to the grocery store, well, you might not because you're a vegetarian, mm-hmm. but a lot of you at home are going to see tomatoes like this.
Right.
And a tomato like this. And right. which one are at home would you choose? Probably the perfect looking tomato. Mm-hmm. Well, the difference is this is like a tomato that is grown all the time, all over mm-hmm. the place, a basic American right. tomato. And this is an heirloom.
Okay.
Now the difference is heirloom tomatoes were cultivated, started back in like the early 1900s, mm-hmm. and people would share their seeds, okay. and their seeds would come together and create new breeds.
Kind of crazy looking.
Yeah,
weird, and some like, of, kind of like this one.
This one's called a yellow taxi.
Oh, nice,
like they have
nice.
The coolest names, and they can grow up to 2 pounds, and I promise you, they have better flavor than these.
They're super delicious.
They like, are so good, and ones like this that we're going to cut into actually look like watermelon.
Oh, when, sweet.
Once you
okay.
cut into it, sweet. So it's really okay. good. So the first thing we're going to want to do, and this recipe is inspired by the chefs at the Cadillac Culinary Challenge. They okay. really, this was one of Chef Gallagher's recipe. First we're going to do is we're going to score the bottom of this.
Okay.
Do you know why we're doing this?
No.
Because we're going to put it in water and we're going to remove the skin.
Oh, perfect. Because so then it'll just peel right off.
Exactly.
Nice.
And
okay.
removing the skin, and that water's hot.
But okay.
You only leave it in there for a couple seconds and then you're going to stick it in an ice bath. Okay.
And then, yes. Okay.
As soon as that comes off, we're going to grab this one. I already had it in there. The
okay.
skin, if you want to start just peeling the skin off,
okay.
the skin will start coming off like that. And then we're going to remove the seeds from it.
Okay.
As I said, this recipe is real simple.
Okay.
As soon as you get all the skin removed off of it, we're going to dice it up and we're going to put it in this bowl with some red onions.
Okay.
Very easy. Okay. And you remember that pesto sauce I made
a while
back? Well, this is a perfect recipe for the pesto sauce.
Okay, so this literally what we did was we put it in the freezer.
Right, we did, and we saved it for a couple other things. Now, you see the seeds on this compared to a normal tomato? All the seeds are on the outside.
That's really weird.
It is, right? So I'm going to cut this in and show everybody what the inside looks like. Just...
Oh my gosh, that looks so strange.
Isn't that, you see how, I don't know if...
Here, we can get a shot right there. Aaron can get it.
How that looks, but it is delicious.
That's
but the
so
seeds, you want to get rid of the seeds because actually seeds are hard to digest.
Uh-huh.
So you try to get rid of the seeds and then we're just going to cut them up into little pieces. But if you look at this, look at how beautiful.
I'm going to move that one.
How beautiful. I mean, it looks like a piece of watermelon.
It does. It looks super delicious.
And we're just going to stick that into our bowl.
Okay.
And then the key to this is the best part of the whole show when I was in Long
uh-huh.
Island, where the two chefs were fighting about seasoning their tomatoes.
Okay.
All right. One chef says you put the salt on right away because he wants to create a broth for his dish. The
okay.
other chef argued that you never season a tomato until right before you serve it.
Interesting.
And you're always supposed to use sea salt.
Okay, so okay. this is sea salt, right?
And did you also know you never refrigerate tomatoes?
No.
Don't ever refrigerate. It takes the flavor away from them.
Interesting, okay.
It actually kills them as soon as you do it. Just a sure. tiny bit of sea salt. And then what happens is once you have all that, the sea
is
salt.
That good?
Yep.
Okay.
You're going to let it sit overnight.
Okay.
Now, salt drains water out of things.
Okay.
So now we have the broth that we're going to
okay.
add to our pesto sauce.
Okay.
And that's going to create the a bouillon.
Okay.
All right. So this is how easy this is now.
This is really nice.
Okay. We're going to take this, mix it up, and here are two bowls. I'm going to ask you to pour a little bit into each one of these bowls.
Okay. Just mm-hmm. some of this.
Yep, some of that.
Okay.
And while you're doing that, what we have done here is you're just going to take a loaf of bread.
Okay. Just a little. Is that
yeah, look at that. It just
more?
Looks like a nice little pesto broth.
Okay.
And you're just going to take pieces like this.
And just crispy it.
And crisp it in butter. That is it.
That's nice. Okay, solid.
So now you're going to take your salad, put it on top of your broth.
Okay.
Wouldn't it be nice if I had a spoon for you?
It's all right. I got this, girl.
I'm all about using my hands, you know?
I know you are. Okay.
And making a mess.
No, it's all right. Okay, we're going to finish this up, and then we'll send it to break. We'll be right back to check out the next product.